Trouble building a lather, too watery, doesn't work out, doesn't look like the guys in the shave of the day pictures or on YouTube. I'll show you a feel-safe way on how you can build a great lather each and every shave. Stay tuned. Chuck Callis with The Shaving Shop, as well as Ariana and Evans. How are you? I hope everyone is doing well. So, I'm going to show you how I build a lather. You know, I see a lot of YouTubers and guys, friends, and some of the lathers just look terrible. And I'm not saying I'm perfect, but I've been doing this a long time, and I think I've gotten it down pretty well, and I'm going to share it with you. It's not so difficult. And whether you're using a $6 drugstore shaving soap or a high-end shaving soap that may cost $50, it doesn't matter. This method will work for any soap, unless it's just really, really bad and it doesn't lather at all. But I'm going to shave with Ultima, our new base, but this will work with anything. I've been using this method for quite some time. The trick is to and it'll work. Geez, I should have soaked a badger, because people will think I'm cheating using the synthetics are just so easy. But we'll use a synthetic, so that's what I have here, because I don't have time to soak. Actually, yeah, I'm gonna soak. Hold on. All right, I'm back. So I have soaking this Brocas Brugi. Shaving brush. I had this custom made. I saw a picture of this and I contacted him. What a great guy. And he made this for me. I saw something very similar. So what I'm doing is I'm just squeezing almost all the water out. I want it so it's barely wet, barely damp. You'll see why. So, toilet sound effects. All right. So what I'm gonna do is just I normally don't bloom soaps. I just put water on it, so it's just on the top, and I empty it out. So I'll do a quick load on this. With synthetics, 30 seconds is more than enough. We'll do maybe a little bit more than 30 seconds. But the whole idea is that you don't want it wet. You don't want the lather overflowing over the jar. You want it really pasty. And because you want to build the lather on your face, or if you use a bowl, you want it in the bowl. So the thing is, when you're doing, not every soap is alike. In fact, they're all different, right? So one particular soap could drown very, very easily if you add too much water. And another soap may require a whole ton of water, gallons of it. So, I find that it's best to always start pasty. This way you can never make a mistake. You gradually add water as needed. So I'm gonna just dip the tips out a little bit more. Again, you want it's very, very dry and pasty. This will work with any soap, but it works exceptionally well with my soaps. A little bit more water, and then we're done. So now I'm gonna just wet the face. And we'll start building a lather. So as you can see, it's like plaster. It's like spackle. So, which is what you want. You want a spackle-like consistency. So now, in fact, most people don't. I dip my brush under the faucet, but you're gonna see, we just dip the tips. Just a little bit. and start building the lather. Dip it again. Again. Now it's starting to come along. But you can't make a mistake because you're in control of everything. And you're just gradually adding water until we get to the desired consistency that you are looking for. Now, some people prefer a really dense lather. I've got that now. Others prefer a wet lather or in between. And I'll get there if I continue. So I'm gonna dip the tips. Dip it again. I'm really good to go if I wanted to, but it's still very, very dense. We could add more. I dipped quite a bit this time. And we'll just do it one more time and then work this particular soap, the Ultima Base, which is yet to be released to the public. We just started shipping to our members. It'll be released to the public in the next 2-3 weeks. This is an ultra, ultra, ultra dense lather. The best that we've done, but we're not here to talk about the soap. We're here to talk about the lather and building a lather. So again, it doesn't matter the soap. The trick is to be in control of your lather each and every time, irrespective of the type of soap that you're using. Now, do it one last time, and then we'll paint. We'll build, then paint, and then we're good to go. I don't know if you're able to see. We built a really nice, cushiony, slick lather. Could have been done with any soap for the most part. With a natural hair brush. I was in complete control of the lather and what I wanted out of the lather. So, to recap, the brush should be barely damp. I mean, more on the dry side. I don't see a need to bloom, but you can just have soap or water soaking it or on laying on top for a few seconds, 30 seconds at most, is more than sufficient. Empty it out. Work the brush 30 seconds, my soap by 30 seconds, but you gauge it. 30 seconds or so, maybe 40 seconds if it's a natural hairbrush. It's really pasty. There's no wet lathers flowing over the jar. You don't want that. You want it pasty. You put it on pasty. And then gradually add water till you get the consistency that you're looking for. So you could say this is a hell of a lather here. All right, I hope that helps you guys. There's no right or wrong way. There's no wrong way to do it. It's whatever works for you. This works for me. I think it'll work for you as well. All right, take care. Bye-bye.